a little tricked up and we'll be able to make a defense. They're going to hate us or not.
Thank you. 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 Hello. o'clock octopus presentation. My name's Roberta. I'm at the back of the room behind the smaller room. How many of you have met a giant Pacific octopus before? Yo, excellent. Now, before we meet our octopus, I'd like to introduce you to a couple of very important people. They come in here, they help us take care of the animals, and today they're going to do their level best. You may or may not be hungry, and it's up to them whether they decide to take the food. Now, I want to introduce you to the real stars. Moving around very nicely, showing off, is Vincent, Umbrella in the large cylinder. Umbrella is the older of our two octopus. He's about 2.5 years old, and he weighs somewhere between 45 and 50 pounds. In the small cylinder, curled up asleep on the rocks right near the surface, is Vincent. Vincent's a little smaller, a little younger. He's somewhere between 1.5 years and 2 years old, and he weighs about 35 pounds. Now, giant Pacific octopus live longer and grow larger than any other species of octopus that we know of in the world. When I say they live longer, it's kind of a relative term. Most octopus species live between 1 and 2 years. The giant Pacific octopus lives between 3 and 5 years, up through Alaska and down the Pacific coast of the United States. And in areas like Alaska, or the outer coast of Washington, where they have lots and lots of good clean water and lots of food, they can top out at over 100 pounds. Quite as good, and food supplies are not quite as plentiful. Our local octopus usually mature at between 60 and 80 pounds. That is size of a grain of rice. An eighth of an inch long, they weigh a fraction of a gram. For the first few weeks of their lives, they're considered plankton. You see, the only hard part of their body is a parrot-like beak in their mouth. Any opening that beak will fit through, the rest of their body will follow. At 45 pounds, Umbrella can fit through an opening the size of a condensed soup can. Many of us enjoy. Who here likes crab? How about clams? Mussels? How about shrimp? Lots of people like shrimp. They will eat all of those things, along with squid and just about anything that swims or crawls in the ocean. So I don't want to stand up here and do all the talking. I want you to shout out your answers nice. All of your arms and legs would be coming out of your lips. Their arms are attached at the bottom of their head, around their mouth, where that parrot-like beak is located. Seems kind of funny, but it works well for them. They can parachute. So if the head is up where their eyes are, what do we call that big bulby sack part that hangs down behind their eyes? Anybody know? You do? What is it? It came out, all the kids know this. But you might ask yourself, why? Why does an octopus need 3 hearts? It turns out their blood is copper-based instead of iron-based like ours. And yes, it is blue. That copper-based blood doesn't transfer the oxygen quite as well as our iron does. What do we call those round things under their arms?
Tentacles.
Ooh, I heard tentacles. The definition of a tentacle is something that's used solely for hunting or feeding. Screw top jars. They can open childproof pill bottles. They can even unscrew nuts and bolts with those suckers. Now those suckers are one more really important part of our octopus. Everybody stick your tongue out at me. We taste with our tongues and our mouths. They taste with their suckers. Well, once again, it works well for them. They hunt at night in our dark, murky waters. They can stick an arm into a crack or a crevice or around a rock, and the arm can tell the octopus whether there's food there to have. Now, we're going to use that sense of taste today because Abby and Mike are going to pour a little juice from those yummy shrimp that they have in their containers into the water. They're going to see if they can get our octopus's attention. Now, what color is Umbrella right now? Is he red? Yeah? Does anybody see what color Vincent was a few minutes ago? It was very gray. Octopus have color cells called chromatophores all over their skin. They expand and contract those cells to change their color. When they go to sleep, all of those cells relax and they turn that gray color. When they're active, the way that umbrella is, they expand all of those cells and they turn bright red. But they can also control them so they can do blotches, patterns on their skin. They can camouflage with their surroundings. So as we wake up our octopus, you might notice them change color. All right, Mike and Abby are gonna lower a piece of shrimp down on a stick. We're gonna put it somewhere near our octopus's suckers. And we're gonna see if we can get their attention and see if they're hungry. Well, Vincent hasn't taken it yet. How about umbrella? Is he interested, Mike?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep, Vincent is definitely awake. He's turned that red color. He's doing a little rotation. Remember I said they parachute over their prey? Sometimes he goes upside down and demonstrates that parachute behavior upside down. Where their mouth is, I told you they were smart, right? Smart animals like to play with things. We have lots of things to entertain our octopus, and we don't want them to get poked with that stick if they yank on it really hard. So we'll let them have it. Oh, maybe. Yeah, there we go. Come back the other way. There. Yep, he tasted that too. That beast. These animals are terminal breeders. They only reproduce one time at the end of their life. As they start to mature, they'll show us signs that they're reaching that stage of their life. We will return them to the wild, to the same location that they came from originally, and a new octopus will come in here and join us. That end part of their life usually lasts between 6 and 8 months. At the end of that time, they simply die, whether they've found willing partners to mate with or not. They will tend the eggs anywhere from 4 to 10 months. They won't leave the den again, and they won't eat again. Wow, Umbrella's really putting on a show today. He's all over the place. Vincent is too. I tell you what, while our octopus are still showing off, this is a terrific opportunity to get up close, check them out. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.